Planet Bomber was a peaceful, thriving place, until Bagla arrived with his army. The preceding war split the planet into five pieces, and the hero, Bomberman, must restore the magical spirit pictures in order to restore Bomber Planet to the way it was, all while defeating Bagla and his army of evil robots. This time, Bomberman's companion, Louie, can provide a helping hand, or so says the instruction booklet. Hello everyone and welcome to my walkthrough of Mega Bomberman. I am PkGam, but you should probably know that by now if you've been on my channel. And yeah, we're gonna start Area 1, the Jammin Jungle. Start button for the win. It starts everything and pauses. And you'll notice that this game has a much different atmosphere than the other Bomberman games I've been playing. This game actually takes place in the Bomberman timeline between Super Bomberman 2 and Super Bomberman 3, so that's why I'm playing this after 2. The chances of me playing 3 through 5 are kind of slim to none because they were never released in America, and being an American, that kind of sucks. So I'm just saying. Anyway, you press the C button to drop bombs. You have one bomb and it explodes with a blast radius of 2. And that little power-up that I got there increased your blast radius by 1 per power-up, with a maximum of 9 if I'm not mistaken. And the objective is to destroy all those crystals and get that piece of the spirit picture inside the center glass globe thingy, the snow globe over there. Okay, it's not actually a snow globe, but it certainly looks like it. The A button detonates remote bombs, and the B button activates the special effect of your Louie friend. Whenever I find a Louie around here, it'll take a little while, but I'm pretty sure there's one on the first level. I certainly hope there's one. That bomb power up there lets you increase the amount of bombs you can drop at once. Like now I can do this by dropping 3 bombs if I'd like to. Yeah, I should say up to 3 bombs because I got those 2 bomb power ups. You should pretty much have the idea of the game by now. You just blow things up, and you gotta love Bomberman for that. It's strategic blow-ups, but blow-ups nonetheless. As you can see, I always avoid my blasts, because if I get hit by my blasts, I'm gonna die. Oh, and you can tell how many of those crystals are left to destroy via those, see those XL things next to the clock at the upper left corner of the screen there? Yeah, those things tell you how many of those crystal ball things you have to destroy. And come on, there must be a Louie around here somewhere. Oh, and there's also another strategic element of this game compared to other Bomberman games in that the soft blocks that you leave on the screen here will actually turn to coins that you can grab for extra lives, you know, for points after you grab that. What does the pink one do? Oh yeah, the pink one only dances. Dang it! Well, at least it's an extra hit. Yeah, all Louies are extra hits to you, so no matter what, even if you've got a kind of useless ability one like this one here, it's still an extra hit, and I appreciate that. 15 seconds! Go, 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 go! Yeah, as you can see, all the soft blocks that remain, they automatically turn into coins, and all enemies that are on the screen as well will just disappear. So if you want more points, you want to destroy the enemies and leave the soft blocks, but at the same time, there's a balance thing in that you want to look for items at the same time, you know, to power up your character. So it's a matter of, do you need more lives or do you need more items? It's a choice that is entirely up to you. So let's start stage 2! Oh, and if you don't know the terminology of Bomberman by now, I'll just explain that as well. Soft blocks are the ones that you can blow up. The hard blocks are the ones like these rocks. Rocks right here. Watch, nothing will happen when I hit that block, see? But hitting the other ones, these little flowers, definitely some effect. Oh, jeez! Blast him. Oh, yeah, you can also blast items if you're not too careful. But I don't need another bomb power-up anyway, so I was just like, eh, whatever. I got plenty of bombs at the time. I don't like... It's not in my play style to drop bombs randomly and vigorously, so I don't need to have more than 3 bombs at one time. See, I'm just sort of pacing myself here, And that's pretty much it. You'll notice that some of the enemies, they... Oh, kick item, awesome! You can walk into bombs and kick them over to the side like that. You can do that to trap things from a distance as well as get just kick your... Like, let's say you get yourself trapped in a corner like this. Well, now you can kick a bomb and get yourself out of it. The kick is a very handy item. There's also Louis that can kick bombs in a different way, which I'll show later if they come up. I believe the blue one is the one that can kick bombs, but they like kick it over soft blocks, or they kick it over blocks in general. This inner tube guy or whatever the heck it is, it sort of homes in on you, so you gotta be careful of that. Those rabbits don't really home in on you. The snails, they're really slow, so I can't even tell if they're homing in on you. But, you know, that's because they're snails. They're supposed to be slow. And this game has bridges and different environments as well compared to other Bomberman games. This game, or say this Bomberman game, is by far my favorite Bomberman of this era. It's just got so much more than other Bomberman games have, but that's likely because it is, you know, third in the timeline of this era, as I was explaining a little bit earlier. That's pretty much it for the basics of Bomberman. Don't turn the corner, please, snail guy. Thank you. I don't know the names of most of the enemies as usual, but in the, you know, bigger context of things, does that really matter? Anyway, I'm going to... I guess I'll take that firepower up, just because it's there. And I'm going to leave those soft blocks just to collect for the coinage! Cha-ching! Pocket change of awesomeness! Woo! And another piece of the puzzle gets put back into place. Notice the 8-bit sound effects that are added in for a nice little touch as well. You'll hear more of them a little bit later. It's kind of funny that they would actually use like 8-bit sound effects in the 16-bit era. But they knew it was charming even back in the day. Stage 3, let's start. I believe this is the first one that you'll see that is separated into areas. You still have to destroy the crystals to progress. So the concept is still the same, but it's not limited to just one screen now. Oh boy. You are a very hyper critter and I'm quite frightened of you. I don't think he's homing in on me though. I mean, he's doing a very bad job of it. go this way. Oh, that works. My blast radius is large enough to hit him anyway. Just to nick him a little. Aha, I trapped you. But that's gonna release the other hyper guy over there. Oh, that right there, that vest, is a invincibility vest, which gives you invincibility for a certain period of time. That's handy for escaping certain situations, but I'm pretty much not going to be using it all that often. Maybe I should have picked that one up just to show you a little trick that you can do with it. But I'll probably be avoiding them in general because I like to show how to beat the stages without those kinds of things. That's kind of the walkthrough-er's way, so to speak. And there we go. That opens ye old door. Any other goodies? No? Okay. Next area! And it's a lot smaller than the other one, that's for sure. And you'll notice that... I wonder what's in that egg. Just for the heck of it, I'm going to blast this Louis. I'm so sorry. And I'm gonna see... It's another pink one! No! I don't want to dance! I want an ability! But I'm sure you'll be able to see all the colors later on. If not, you'll definitely be able to see all the colors. Oh, in battle mode, I did not want him to come over to this side. By the way, blasts do not cross bridges, so you're safe on bridges, except from enemies. You know what, I guess you could cross over here if you want to. It's much more wide open, but I would actually prefer him to be over there because of the fact I can trap him easily, or I should say easier. Come on, go up here, thank you very much. And if there's not anything in there, I won't have to go back. Good. Oh, and don't worry about blasting any doors or those crystal snow globes over there. Unlike other Bomberman games, you will not respawn the enemies. They got rid of that in this version of the game, so... Yeah, just thought I would mention that as well. I would like to blast the bunny just because I can blast the bunny. The boxing bunny. And there we go. Should I... Nah, I'm powered up enough. I'll just get them as coins. I believe every 20,000 points you get an extra life. I don't quite remember exactly. But anyway, that's the end of the stage, and I just noticed I was really low on time there. I wasn't paying attention to the clock at all. I was just going on my jolly way. Panic! 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 And this is the boss known as Fang Banana. Yeah, we have to battle I and a giant banana. Your best bet is just to blast that monkey. Really, that's all there is to it. And, well, and avoid that guy, you know, the giant banana over there, but I don't think he really homes in on you all that much. I think when the monkey zaps, like, that little remote control thing. Yeah, look at its face, it's on fire. When it zapped it with that remote control, I think it makes it home in on you, but I'm not quite sure on that. It's an extremely easy boss. Just blast the monkey and you'll win. don't get too close to the monkey, otherwise it'll move, but that's really all there is to it. I'm sure you can also do it by, you know, beating the big banana as well, you know, Fang Banana itself. And one piece of the pizza goes right back into play. Seriously, it does look like a pizza. You can't tell me anything different. Or a pie chart. Okay, so I guess you could tell me something different. And that's all I'm going to be doing in this part. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part when I start Area 2, the Vexen Volcano. Yeah, they use slang names in this game. Just for a little extra charm there. Anyway, I'm rambling. Doo-doo-doo!